carries this exercise out annually against these 23 data centers. So they have a true benchmark capability. Unfortunately, the PUE has not improved in those data centers in the last 3 or 4 years. The Singapore government recognized that that was going to be the case fairly early on. And they brought up a number of Singapore standards, primarily SS564, which is energy efficiency standard. And another standard they have is called Green Mark. And these measure the efficiency, the energy efficiency, and the operating efficiency of the data centers in Singapore. It's a very simple measurement. And I'm quite proud because I was part of the development of both of those standards. The Singapore government have taken these on and are driving this initiative to have more efficient data centers. And you know when something is fairly good, when somebody else copies it. So the Hong Kong government now have HK564. They took off SS, put HK, and the standard is identical. Singapore government don't mind because it's promoting their energy efficiency standard. And I don't mind because we're now getting some standardisation. And that's very important because there is a lack of standardisation in the data centre marketplace. So when the Uptime Institute, for example, says the Uptime Institute standard, you have to remember that that is with a small s. The Uptime Institute has a small I. It's not like the University of Nottingham, which is an educational institute. You have to remember that people like the Uptime Institute, HP, sell business. They are selling you what they think is the correct service that you want. Uptime Institute, two engineers, very clever idea, developed it into a multi-million dollar business. And we take it that it is the industry standard, but it has to be taken with a small s. And I doubt that we will ever get a single international standard for data center efficiency management. There are too many. ASHRAE, the American plumbing and heating standard. BISRIA and SIPSI from the UK. Australia has neighbours. There's the EU Code of Conduct on Data Centre Design. There's the EU Code of Conduct on Data Centre Operations. So all of these codes and standards don't come together. They conflict with each other considerably, particularly the American, the British and European standards. So we need to be looking at how we can benchmark our efficiency ourselves. And we need to be able to meet our individual requirements. And the fact that we have in Malaysia very high temperatures is not an issue to a data center. We have high temperatures in Singapore. We have high temperatures in Dubai, which is where I came from before taking on the role in Singapore. And we were operating data centers at 50 degrees centigrade with no problem at all. The problem comes with humidity. It's a combination of temperature and humidity where you are going to face the challenge in Malaysia, in this tropical region. And that's something we need to address. Our keynote speakers mentioned some of the ways that we can address those issues.